Welcome to another video on using the first derivative to determine whether a function is increasing or decreasing, as well as how to determine the relative extrema. You may want to watch my previous videos on this topic. I do go over the explanations in much more detail. The biggest difference for this video is I will provide examples using trigonometric functions. But let's go ahead and review the major concepts. This function in blue has a relative minimum because it changes from decreasing to increasing, which can be determined where the first derivative changes from negative to positive. The second function has a relative maximum at x equals c because the function changes from increasing to decreasing, which will be indicated by the first derivative changing from positive to negative. And then lastly, sometimes when you have a critical number, there may not be a relative extrema. For example, in this case, x equals 0 would be a critical number, but the first derivative does not change sign on either side of x equals 0. So the general rules to determine where a function is increasing or decreasing, as well as how to find relative extrema, are as follows. Step 1, we're going to find the critical numbers, which is where the first derivative is equal to 0 or it's undefined. And then we'll use these numbers to determine test intervals. Then we'll determine the sign of the first derivative in each interval. First derivative is positive, the function is increasing over the interval. If it's negative, it's decreasing over the interval. Then, based upon the sign changes of the derivative, we'll determine if we have a relative max or min. If relative extrema exist, we will find them by evaluating the original function at the x value. So let's go ahead and give it a try. So on this first example, we want to find the open intervals for which the function is increasing or decreasing, and then also find the relative extrema. So we'll first find the derivative. That would be 1/2 minus sine x. This is never undefined, so let's set it equal to 0 and solve. Having sine x equal to 1/2 should remind you of a 30 degree reference angle, but sine is also positive in the second quadrant. So our two critical numbers are x equals 30 degrees or pi over 6, and also in the second quadrant, we'd have 5 pi over 6 radians. So what we'll do now is we'll use these critical numbers and divide up our interval from 0 to 2 pi with these values. So to save some time, I've already done that. The first interval would be from 0 to pi over 6, then from pi over 6 to 5 pi over 6, and then lastly, 5 pi over 6 to 2 pi. So again, x equals pi over 6 was one critical number, and x equals 5 pi over 6 was our second critical number. Now we'll pick a test value in each of these intervals. Well, I know that pi over 6 is the same as 2 pi over 12, so I'll pick pi over 12. Something between 1 pi over 6 and 5 pi over 6, how about 2 pi over 6 or pi over 3? And then lastly, 5 pi over 6 is the same as 10 pi over 12, so I'll pick 11 pi over 12. What we're going to do now is type the derivative function into our calculator and use it to determine the sign in each of these intervals. Okay, we'll go to our table and we'll type in our test values. We had pi over 12, pi over 3, and then lastly we had 11 pi over 12. Now remember, we're only concerned about the sign, so notice that pi over 12, it's positive, pi over 3, it's negative, 11 pi over 12, it's back to positive. Let's go ahead and record this in our table. So it was positive, negative, and then positive. And that tells us on this interval it's increasing, or it's going uphill. On this interval it's decreasing because the derivative was negative, so it's going back downhill. And then this interval it's positive, so it's increasing, going back uphill. So that's half the question. Now we know where it's increasing and decreasing, and now we need to determine our relative extrema. Well, if the function changes from increasing to decreasing, we must have a relative maximum at x equals pi over 6. And at 5 pi over 6, it changes from decreasing to increasing. That would be a low point, so we have a relative minimum there. Now these are just the locations of the relative extrema. The y-coordinate is actually the relative max or min, so we need to go back and determine the y-values of the original function at these x-values. So we need to find f of pi over 6 and f of 5 pi over 6. So here's our original function. Well, pi over 6 divided by 2 would be pi over 12 plus the cosine of pi over 6. And the cosine of pi over 6 is square root 3 over 2. So this would be our relative maximum. And our relative minimum would be 5 pi over 6 divided by 2, that's 5 pi over 12, plus the cosine of 5 pi over 6. Well, cosine is negative in the second quadrant, so this would be negative square root 3 over 2. We may want to get some decimal approximations for these. Okay, so I went ahead and found the decimal approximations for these relative max and relative min, so we could now compare on a graph. Let's go ahead and take a look. We said that pi over 6, we had a relative maximum, which is right here. You can see this value is a little more than 1. And here we have a relative minimum at 5 pi over 6, which was about 0.44. So our graph looks good compared to our work. Thank you for watching.